This will be the first video lecture in a series of lectures covering the cell membrane transport. Keep in mind that the purpose of cell membrane transport is to move solutes into or out of a cell. So this is the prior knowledge that you should know before proceeding with this video lecture. If you're unsure of any of these answers, be sure to go back to the previous material and brush up on these concepts. So here's our chapter outline that will be discussed in this particular chapter on membrane transport. This video lecture is going to be focusing on the factors that affect the direction of transport. So before we begin, it's important for us to review the driving forces that act on molecules, and this is a very fundamental concept here. And so that concept is random thermal motion or Brownian movement. And so the question is, do molecules prefer to move from a high energy state to a low energy state, or do they prefer to move from a low energy state to a high energy state? So take a moment to think about that and then answer this question. You could even pause the video if you'd like. And so when you talk about random thermal motion, remember that that is synonymous with Brownian movement. And what that means is that molecules are always moving. And since molecules are always moving, that means then that they're going to collide. And every time they collide and they bounce off one another and collide into another molecule and bounce off and collide into another and so on, every time this happens, they generate energy. And it's this energy that pushes molecules in one direction or another. And so the direction then that these molecules prefer to move is from a high energy state toward a lower energy. Okay, so now with that in mind, let's go ahead and review the driving forces that are affecting the direction of movement or the membrane transport. So let's begin with the chemical driving force. A chemical driving force is the same thing as a concentration gradient. So if you hear the term chemical gradient or you hear the term concentration gradient, those are the same thing. So we're going to abbreviate concentration gradient with a change in C. Because what we mean by a change in C is that there's a difference in concentration. We will always use brackets to abbreviate concentration. So we have a difference in concentration across the membrane. So this is just a real brief introduction to what a chemical gradient is. We'll get into more detail in just a moment on that. Then there's the electrical driving force. Within electrical driving force, now you need to think about having a difference in the net charge across the membrane. So once again, we'll be returning to the electrical driving force here shortly. Lastly, there's also an electrochemical driving force, and so that's a combination of both the chemical plus the electrical driving force. We'll return to electrochemical driving forces later on in the semester. And so first, let's go ahead and focus on a chemical driving force. And so remember, when in a chemical driving force, you always have to think about a concentration gradient. And so when you look at figure A, is there a concentration gradient illustrated in figure A? The red dots illustrate the solute. The blue background is your extracellular fluid. So those red dots there are the solute in the extracellular fluid. The tan color within the cell is representing the solutes in the intracellular fluid. And so hopefully you responded, yes, there is a concentration gradient. There's a lot more solutes, right, in the intracellular fluid. So here we have a high concentration in the intracellular fluid compared to the extracellular fluid where there's a low concentration. So in this particular case, you're going to have more collisions or a high frequency of collisions, in other words, in the intracellular fluid, which generates a lot of energy and pushes or provides the energy to push those solutes out of the cell. And then if you look at figure B, we have a similar situation in the sense that, yes, there is a concentration gradient, but this time the gradient is into the cell. So solutes want to move into the cell because there's a higher concentration of solute in the extracellular fluid, a lower concentration of solute in the intracellular fluid. You generate more collisions, so you have a high frequency of collisions in the extracellular fluid, which then generates more energy. And then that pushes those solutes into the cell because there's more energy there. So now let's introduce an additional concept here. And so we want to think about the magnitude of the driving force. And what we want to know is the magnitude of the driving force proportional to the concentration gradient. Okay, so to study this a little more closely, let's take two elevators. So here's going to be elevator A, and right next to it's going to be elevator B. So you can imagine that these are elevators in the parking garage. Elevator A has 20 people. Outside of elevator A, there's one person. Elevator B has 5 people, and outside of elevator B, there's also one person. So which of these elevators is going to have a greater concentration gradient, A or B? Elevator A has a higher concentration gradient. Remember, a concentration gradient is the concentration difference across the membrane. So in elevator A, there's 20 people inside and one person outside. So if you have 20 people crammed inside of that elevator, they're going to generate a lot of energy because they're going to have a lot of collisions. And so if you look at figure B, there's only 5 people in the elevator. So will they have as many collisions as those that are in elevator A? And the answer is no. There's fewer collisions, therefore there's less energy. So there's not as strong of a gradient. So figure A has a larger driving force. So the magnitude of the driving force is definitely proportional to the concentration gradient. The greater the magnitude, the greater the gradient. Next, then, we turn to the electrical driving force. And so in the electrical driving force, remember that we're dealing with charges, solutes that have charges. So in the intracellular fluid, there's all sorts of ions, anions, cations, and so on in the intracellular fluid. But the idea here is that you have a net negative charge in the intracellular fluid, meaning you have more negatively charged ions in the intracellular fluid than you do cations. And then in the extracellular fluid, there's a net positive, meaning there's more cations than there are anions in the extracellular fluid. So we're going to be representing this a little bit differently throughout the course. And so to the right, here we have a cell. And this cell in the intracellular fluid, we know, has a net negative charge. So we'll be representing that with a negative along the inside of this membrane. And then we know that the extracellular fluid is outside of the cell, and it has a net positive charge. So we'll be illustrating that with a positive on the outside of this membrane. So once you see this, then you can ask yourself, is there an electrical gradient? And you should say, yes, there's an electrical gradient because there's a difference in charges across the membrane. Another way to put it is there's a charge separation across the membrane. Okay, so then when we look at these two images, let's look at figure A here, and we want to know, why is the driving force into the cell? So if we have a net positive, right, in the extracellular fluid and a net negative in the intracellular fluid, why do the positives want to move in? Well, remember, opposites attract. And so positives want to move into the cell where it's negative, right? They're attracted to the opposite charge. And then a similar situation in figure B. Now they have a situation where the negatives want to move out because they're attracted to the positives on the outside of the cell. So that's just showing you the direction of movement based on attraction of these charged solutes. Okay, and then lastly is electrochemical driving force. Again, we're going to return to this concept later.